Hi, it's Ashley, everybody. This is your aunt. Today, we are doing the four episodes of the Miracle America reaction. So, there's going to be this episode, and then the next episode of this is going to be the final episode. That's the By the way, guys, thank you for 40 subscribers. I'm so happy now because I'm in a good mood because I just realised we got 40 subscribers. Last time I checked, we only had 38, so thank you for that. So let's just get right into it. Oh, by the way, shout out to Chloe. Let's go. You will end. Please. Okay, thank you.
Home without a camera. You're a time traveler. You've traveled across several different timelines and relived this month over and over. Always looking for a way to change the outcome into the one you want. The truth about you does answer one important question, though. It solves the mystery of why Madoka Kaname has so much incredible potential as a magical girl. At last, I have a theory that explains it. A magical girl's potential is based on the weight of the karmic destiny she bears. If she were a queen or messiah, I could have understood. But Madoka was given an ordinary life. So it was hard for me to understand why she would be the focal point for so many destinies. But now, say, Homura, could it be that Madoka's potential to become the most powerful magical girl is because you kept turning back time? I thought so. You are the cause of it. Or rather, a side effect of your magic caused her to become that way. What do you mean? There's only one reason you kept repeating this timeline, to save Madoka Kaname. By turning back time over and over, and each time for the same reason, you unknowingly caused these multiple timelines to converge. And they all converge around Madoka Kaname. The threads of fate of all the Madokas in all the different timelines were never linked before, but if they converged upon a single point, the Madoka in this timeline, then that would explain why she has the powerful magical potential she has. All of the karmic destinies, from all the different timelines you affected, eventually attach themselves to Madoka Kaname. After all, she's the reason this happened.
My mind is safe.
Excellent work, Kamada. You've made Madoka the most powerful witch ever.
Wow.
It sounds like sex and sort of like
that.
What's that? I don't get this other way anymore. It's really bad. It might be a short sex, I'm not sure. Because I'm not sure if it's so I want the five episodes to be like dramatic. In the next episode, I will be wearing a hat. This bit is also the main part.
Tragic news. The body of an 8th grade student from Nitakihara Public Middle School has been identified as Sayaka.
No! Sayaka!
Her body was discovered today in a room at a downtown hotel, and police are still investigating whether her death was murder or suicide. Up next, the weather. Heavy rain, moderate wind coming from northwest.
Come inside.
Yeah.
shouldn't come as such a surprise. It would have happened sooner or later.
Okay.
But that doesn't make it okay. It's your fault they're dead, and you act like it doesn't matter. Do you feel any guilt or remorse for the livestock you consume? Have you ever thought about all those animals that are on the
phone?
Your reaction isn't very rational. If you don't like the things you saw just now, I'm afraid you're missing the big picture. Humans chose livestock to be food. In exchange, they are fed, allowed to reproduce, and protected from predators all their lives. Cows, pigs, and chickens have a much higher rate of survival in captivity, more than they would in the wild. So you see, the relationship is mutually beneficial for both parties. On the contrary, we treat humans with much more respect than humans treat their livestock. We acknowledge your species as a sentient one, and try to deal fairly with you. Don't you believe me? Would you like me to show you proof? Humans and the incubators have shared history together. We have intervened in your civilization's development since prehistoric times. Throughout the ages, countless girls have made contracts with incubators, had their wishes granted, and then succumbed to despair. Beginning with a wish and ending with a curse. It's the cycle every magical girl has repeated up to now. Some have started revolutions that changed history, while others elevated human society to new levels. They shouldn't have made the wish in the first place. Don't get me wrong. I don't think they're foolish. It was thanks to their sacrifices that human society developed as far as it has.
No! You be so evil!
It was the suffering of all the magical girls throughout history that laid the foundation for the life you have now. If your civilization benefits from their sacrifice, why should the lives of the few people matter in the grand scheme of things?
A lot of people do it, but
didn't you ever feel anything? Didn't you ever try to understand? Couldn't you see how much pain they were in? If we were capable of comprehending such things, we wouldn't have come to your planet in the first place.
I hate you, babe.
You see, in our society, the phenomenon you call emotion is considered a mental disorder. We were surprised when we discovered the human species. We never imagined there'd be a world where each individual had their own set of emotions yet still managed to coexist with one another. So then, if your kind of never come to Earth and manifest, the truth is, you humans would most likely still be living naked, in caves. It's a shock, losing one of your own students.
I love Sayaka. Sayaka, why? Sayaka! I'm not having you.
She knows she can come to me, but whatever I've met you over and over, and every time, to watch you die. What do I have to do to save you? What do I have to do to change your fate? I keep doing this month over again, searching for the answer. But I'm sorry. I'm not making any sense. It's scary, you are trying. You really barely know me. Just started going to school, so it's not like you really know me. But I know you. I know you so well. Everything's messed up. The more we do this time, the further apart we get. Feel my words, nothing gets through to you. I'm out of options. I don't know what to do anymore. I will see. The one thing I wished for. That's how it started. And now it's the only thing I have left to guide me. And it's okay if you don't understand anything I'm saying. But please, let me protect you.
I feel like crying with someone else. But I'm not good at
the updraft's getting faster now. Pick up those clouds. A supercell's forming, no doubt about it. Issue the evacuation order.
Due to extreme weather conditions, an evacuation order is being issued for 7 a.m. Attention, this is a public service announcement in Ohio City. Due to extreme weather conditions, an evacuation order is being issued for 7 a.m.
Here.
one here.
Still on a bridge.
What's wrong, Mother-Buck?
Going to the bathroom. Do you think Homura's gonna be able to feed it all by herself?
If I told you no, what difference would it make? You wouldn't believe me. Explanations are pointless now. If you want to know, you should go have a look. See for yourself how Homura Akemi is doing against Valpurga's mouth.
Do you know why she's being so stubborn about it?
Because she hasn't given up hope, that's why. If things don't work out, she'll just negate this timeline and start it all over again. She'll go on, and keep right on fighting, and continue this meaningless chain of events. At this point, it's not possible for her to stop or give up. That's not an option anymore. You see, the moment she acknowledges that everything she's done is pointless, and your fate's impossible to change, Homura Akemi will fall into despair and turn into a grief. She knows it to be true, and that's why she has no choice. She has to keep fighting, regardless of whether she can win or not.
So you're saying as long as she thinks there's hope, she's doomed?
That's right. Just like it was for all the past magical girls. Remember, Marika? You've seen it.
Marika! She died, girl. I like it. Let's see you die. Oh, okay. Bye. Goodbye. Goodbye, Steve. She's got out.
Where do you think you're going?
I have to go outside to save a friend.
The fire department can take care of it. You need to stay here.
But I'm the only one who can do this!
You can't just go off and do what you want! Don't you know how much we worry about you if you just went out there without saying anything?
I know. I do, Mom. Really. I know how you and Dad would feel because I love you too. I understand how much you and Dad care about me.
Okay,
and I know I have to be careful. I do. But this is different. I have to protect you because of how much I care about you. And I can do it. But the only way I can help is if you let me go right now!
Sure you don't want to tell me what this is about? Okay, then I'm coming with you.
Mom, it's better if you stay with Dad and talk to them. Someone has to make sure they're safe too. You told me once that you did a good job of raising me, and you're right, you did. I don't tell lies, and I don't do bad things. I need you to trust that I'm doing the right thing.
Yeah. My fingernails, my thumb.
And you're sure you're not making a mistake. No one's lying to you or trying to trick you.
I'm sure. Thank you, Mom. I love you.
I love you too.
I have to stop it if it gets any closer to the evacuation center. Whatever happens, I can't let it get any further.
Try to do.
Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you enjoyed. Thanks for watching, guys. Good get sleep, potiously, get sleep, blah, 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 blah. Bye.